And on business news, the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Education and Sports, Asuman Lukwago, has stressed the need for international accreditation of technical institutions to enhance the quality of standards in the oil sector. Lukwago made the remarks at the City and Guilds accreditation launch in Kampala, where three institutions were accredited to teach technical courses at the international level.
Namwanyago, Kabasi and Iganga Technical Institutes have joined Chiliandongo Oil and Gas Institute to teach technical courses at an international level and will deliver guilds and build certificate. The Permanent Secretary, Minister of Education and Sports, Alex Kakoza, says that this is part of the strategic plan in the Skilling Uganda initiatives.
Also want to appeal to you as the institutes to market the qualification you have got. Because, as you know, I've already talked about the study plan. Part of that study plan was to change the perception of TVET in this country, to rebrand it. Because in the past, you know, people thought TVET is the option, the last option. If you fail to do any other thing, you go to TVET.
Alex Kakoza assured Ugandans that they will be a priority in selection to oil and gas jobs and that they should acquire the technical skills.
That the industry should tell us the kind of skills they want our people to have, and therefore the people they are going to employ. The industry will determine the curriculum, therefore, so that the skills they expect our people to have are factored into the curriculum, and then we deliver the curriculum. That curriculum would be competence-based, and that curriculum would ensure that our people get skills that make them competitive.
Betty Namubiru, a content manager in the oil and gas sector, said over 160,000 employees, especially technicians, are needed, but should have a business technical vocation education training certification.
The support to skills development is continuing. There are lots of training efforts for government officials to acquire these international accreditations, both in Uganda National Oil Company, Petroleum Authority of Uganda, but also with Ministry of Education, Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development. And that has put us to over 200 officers that have been trained. We have the National Oil and Gas Talent Register. This is supporting registration of talent so that they are visible to the investors in the industry.
Betty said the oil sector is going to be among the biggest investment sectors in the country, and the need for preparing technicians and equipping institutions with oil and gas skills is more needed than never before.
The challenge ahead of us, or the opportunity, the magnitude of investment in the development phase is up to $20 billion. So what does it mean for us as Ugandans? What does it mean? How much do we have to prepare to seize these opportunities?
The Principal Association of Public Technical and Vocational Institutions of Uganda, Engineer Triatemba Edi, said their vision is to have competitive graduates globally with a high rate of professionalism, innovation with high commitment.
To get at this accreditation, you would have to move, the nearest would be South Africa. And now all those costs of movement or hiring those experts to come here, now all those costs will be mitigated.
A National Oil and Gas Talent Register has also been introduced, where a person having skills in oil and gas is registered. Sudat Kaye and Sabira Andrew, UBC News.
And the Private Sector Foundation has launched a